boxer rescue. How many, Sherry, how old?
He's about 4 months old.
4 months old. Mm-hmm. So today we're just going to work with Finn a little bit, see his little prey drive game. He's having fun. Oh, good job. And I'm talking with Sherry to, when you have a puppy, we're just going to work on getting engagement first, the dog to look at her, mark it with a yes. When the dog's looking at you, especially puppies, yes, we've been out here a while and he's kind of tired. And so I'll change with food and I'll get the toy from him. But mainly what I want Sherry to do is mark the yes when the dog looks at her. The dog doesn't have to be in a sit or anything. So if he jumps up on you, you don't mark that. But if he looks at you when he jumps up, she's going to mark that because he's a puppy. And step back and give the reward. So engagement for about a week with a puppy and get the dog to trust you. Then there's another engagement that we do with puppies, which I'll show. So Sherry has this. Put that in the tree, make it go away. Because I want Sherry to do a lot of engagement work with the puppy. It's not about treats. If they're food motivated, we want the dog fed from your hand at all times. And then fed inside the crate, okay? So that's important also. So then when we do engagement, where the treat comes from, or the dog food, is this. This is luring. Found one on the ground. And we'll get his attention. And yes, look at that. So all we're doing right now is engagement. And I was sharing with Sherry that way. If your dog got offline, it's not about calling their name or using their name. It's about movement. And the dog gets rewarded for coming to you. So Sherry's going to work on this for about 1 to 2 weeks. Just eye engagement. The dog looks at her. Sherry's not going to use any hand contact. Look at me. She's not going to say anything. She's going to stand there, do nothing. And when the dog looks her in the eye, Sherry's going to mark it with a yes. Then she's going to come out with the treat. So that's important that you take that picture moment of yes, then the movement. But have your rewards. Don't go digging afterwards. Otherwise, the dog starts looking for that movement. So be ready. Have your treats behind you. You look at the dog. And when the dog looks at you, he's kind of tired. We've already been out here a little bit. But if he was to look at me, as soon as he looks at my eyes, I would go yes. And then I'll step back, yes. And I'd step back and give the reward. Okay? No hands up into your face or anything like that. Finn, yes. Good job. That I was rewarding because Sherry wants him to, you know, respond to his name. And remember, don't get hung up on their names because too many humans tend to go, and I'm going to use him as an example. Sorry, Sherry. But too many humans basically will go, Finn, why'd you get into that trash? Or why'd you do this? And why'd you do that? Don't. Their name is only used in a positive way. If I wanted to get their attention, what I mean by positive is if I was to say, I'm going to use a different name right now so I don't confuse him. If I was going to call my name to my dog and said, Boo-ray, meaning she's ready to get hit by a car and go, Boo-ray, and she doesn't look at me, when I do go into no, I'm not using her name as a negative. The positive was I was calling her name, she ignored it, no, because she took another step forward. She didn't look at me. As soon as she looked at me, I went, yes, and I started backing up. Don't go towards your dog if it's running away. Don't go towards your dog. Movement. So Sherry's going to work on a lot of hand movements. Low, because this becomes a toy and a target. If you reward your dog always like this and go fiddling in your treat bag, sometimes put your treat bag behind you and the dog doesn't know where it's coming from, or either your pockets, vary it up. That's important. To vary up where they come from. And when I say treats, I also mean their dog food when they're puppies. So you can distribute the amount in your pockets for the day. You can have it in here for the day. And then that way, when the dog goes to eat again, I'm going to repeat this, is that you're going to do it from your hand doing something. The dog's going to earn the food. So the dog starts looking for you for everything. Sherry's having came here today because she was concerned about walking the dog. But until we can have the dog engaging with her in her own environment, up and down her driveway, in her front yard, the dog can't handle anything further out there. It's a puppy. Puppies see leaves and this and that. So Sherry's going to do at least a week of good work in the yard. She'll progress out her street, maybe just from mailbox to mailbox. Maybe only 10 feet to 10 feet. As soon as the dog checks out, she'll go back to where she got the right behavior and work there for a couple more days. So don't move too fast. Take the time. Don't talk a lot to your dogs. They really just like movement. They want to know where, you know, their rewards are coming from. They want to be able to trust you. And Finn is, it's hot. He's checking out. All right, thanks.